हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज रेवन फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 260। IBM and Samsung have announced during the IADM conference in San Francisco reveal a breakthrough in semiconductor design by unveiling a new design for stacking transistors vertically on a chip. In the new vertical transport field effect transistors, transistors sit perpendicular to one another and the current flows through them vertically. For those who are unaware, in the current processor and the system on chips, transistors lie flat on the surface and get an electric current flows from side to side. This new kind of transistor could allow for a greater density of these components per chip compared to anything that is available at present, thus their potential for improved power efficiency or performance. Apple is set to launch 4 models under its iPhone 14 series next year. Both iPhone 14 Pro models are set to come with a 48-megapixel wide-angle camera. Both iPhone 14 Pro models are set to pack 8GB of RAM. Robots have been evolving for decades. The technology we know today was only a dream in the past and the star of fictional movies. Artificial intelligence started out being very rudimentary compared to what we know now. The first humanoid robot, Sophia, surprised everyone with her appearance, but still does not compare with those who follow her. Last week, the Engineered Arts company posted a video showing its latest creation. The head of the new Mesmer robot is strikingly similar to the human face. In the publication, the robot imitates various facial expressions. This is possible thanks to fact that they are designed and built with the 3D scans of real people. Nipun Maria will now serve as a CEO of IQ India. He aims to double the 5% market share of IQ in India by next year. The company also seeks to increase the pace of innovation in its products. IQ had officially announced the launch date for its upcoming Neo 5S smartphone. The company has started teasing the upcoming handset, showcasing its dual-chip technology and other features. The Neo 5S is set to be officially unveiled on 28 December 2021. It is expected to launch with a 120Hz display along with the 12GB of LPDDR5 RAM and up to 256GB of UFS 3.1 storage. Other features include 48-megapixel triple camera setup on the rear, while the front houses a 16-megapixel selfie shooter. It will even support 66-watt fast charging and ship with an Origin OS Ocean UI based on Android OS. Netflix has reduced the pricing of its plans in India. The new plans are being dubbed as Happy New Prices. The new Netflix Indian plan prices will come into effect on Tuesday on December 14th. The Xiaomi 12 will be unveiled later this month on December 28th, and it will bring the new MIUI 13 along with it. The logo for the new OS version have leaked through Xiaomi's feedback application and continues a geometric design trend of version 12. TechnoSpark 8T will be launching in India today at 12 noon. The landing page has gone up on Amazon India. It features a MediaTek Helio G85 processor, 33-watt fast charging support, and a 50-megapixel camera. Vivo Watch 2 launch date has been confirmed. Earlier today, the company confirmed that it will be launching the Vivo S12 series of smartphones on December 22nd in China. The company has now confirmed that it will be unleashing the Vivo Watch 2 along with the S12 lineup. Realme 9i has received the FCC certification with the model number RMX3941. The listing has revealed the phone would come with a triple cameras, Android 11 OS and a 5000mAh battery. Realme 9 series is expected to debut in the first half of 2022. Realme GT 2 Pro appears on China's 3C certification with the model number RMX3300. The listing shows the phone will come with a 5G connectivity and a 65-watt DART charging. The Realme GT 2 Pro is set to go official at a special event on December 20th. Xiaomi 12 Ultra render shows off a large circular camera module on the back. This handset could ship with a triple camera array, punctual cutout and a slightly curved edges. Xiaomi 12 Ultra specifications may include a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor, a 6.8-inch AMOLED display and a 50-megapixel primary camera. Redmi 10 2022 can be seen on the Google Play console listing with the two RAM options of 4GB RAM and a 6GB RAM. It has a screen resolution of 1080x2400 pixels, meaning it will offer a full HD plus display. This phone should launch with Android 11 out of the box with MIUI 12.5 on top. Sahara Evolve X1 electric scooter catches fire in Andheri, Mumbai. Super Eco Automotive, the manufacturer, has claimed to investigate the matter and reported that battery packs are sourced externally. Industry specialists request more stringent laws as this is a fourth electric vehicle related fire since September. Huawei has announced that the company will be holding a new launch event to unveil its new flagship smartphone, Huawei P50 Pocket, which appears to be a new foldable smartphone from the brand. The launch event will take place on 23rd December at 3:30 PM local time in China. Along with the flagship smartphone from Huawei, Huawei has officially announced that it will be hosting a new winter product launch conference later this month. One of the products that will be unveiled in the launch event is the Watch D. The Watch D is now available for the registrations. The Watch D is said to be the Chinese tech giant's first smartwatch that will feature the blood pressure tracking. Pune-based Northway Motorsport has launched an electric vehicle conversion kit for Maruti Ignis. The conversion kit will be available for Ignis MT 2021 and later models. The conversion kit will be offered in two battery pack options with a range of 120 km and 240 km respectively. The electric conversion kit available at a starting price of Rs 12.5 lakhs. PUBG New State scheduled December maintenance and subsequent update have been delayed yet again. With the dev citing continuous delay in the app review as the reason, PUBG New State was set to receive a major update on December 9. But the maintenance routine has been pushed back a couple of times now. As part of the delay, the PUBG New State is giving some little compensation. Players will be receiving rewards on a daily basis until the maintenance is complete and the update has arrived. For today's reward, players will receive 2 chicken medals. The number of chicken medals received will increase by 1 each day until the day of maintenance. Although the reward is pretty decent, players have to be disappointed with the lack of new content at the time it was originally supposed to arrive. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.